Hey, what's going on, guys? Okay, so I'm here with my Retevis RT18. These are little handheld radios that I picked up from eBay. They're very, very nice and compact. These are FRS radios. And what I wanted to do was figure out which radios to keep. And so I have a pair of FRS radios here, and I have a set of MURS radios here. These are also the Retevis RB17v. These are really compact, and these are a little bit bigger, definitely an antenna size. So I really wanted to compare the two, and I couldn't find anybody doing this straight up comparison. A lot of them had GMRS in it involved, and I just wanted to find out two license-free radios and see, put them head-to-head and see what we get. Alrighty, so this is, go over this one real quick. Since this is the RT18, it's nice, it's got two PTT buttons, one in the front and one on the side. So that's nice, it's got two little ways. The belt clip itself clips, it's a screw that goes right into the body. And it doesn't come off. There's no real adjustment to it. It's just a metal plate. The battery is just a small 1000 milliamp battery. This feels more of a toy, which is okay. It fits in your pocket very nicely. They're really tiny. Now, the MURS, this is the RB17v. The V is the MURS indicator. There are five channels on the MERS system, and the FRS has 16 channels. So I'm gonna set the channel one, and then we're gonna do a test real quick to see what kind of range we can get this versus this. So let's go ahead and do that, because I know that's what you're here for. You're here to see the range of this. So let's go ahead and put this there.
Turn on the radio.
Radio check. Testing. There it goes. Okay. Radio check. Testing. There we go. So we got the two radios here side by side. One of the advantages of this one is that it's very easy to stand up, as you see. And there you go. So it's harder to keep this one standing up. This is very scientific. Okay. Radio check, all right. Both working. So let's go check the range of this and see what we get. Let me set my cell phone up and I'll be right back. All right, let's go for a drive. Okay, we're all set. Alright guys, well there you go. Not bad. I gotta say, between the two, I'm going MERS. The FRS one time didn't actually respond, didn't see it. The MERS picked it up, and then at about 3,100 feet, I thought the MURS was clearer than the FRS. So, you know, my unscientific approach is MURS all the way. The other reason I like the MURS more too is because of the grip and the antenna. If I want to get a little longer range, I can take this off and get a longer antenna. It's a USB-C straight to the body, so I don't need to carry an extra charger. This is the old style charger, which is the micro USB, which is fine, not really a big thing, but this also has a standby time of, it says 24 days, which is, seems pretty ridiculous, but I know at 4,400 milliamp battery is gonna outlast a 1,000 milliamp battery many times over. So this one is going back. I said earlier I bought it from eBay. I meant Amazon. I don't know why I said eBay. I always buy stuff from eBay and Amazon. I get them confused. MURS all the way. MURS all the way. MURS is the winner. Now, I'm in Maryland and we're hilly. So some of these tests from, you can't really tell the topology, but they are hilly. So sometimes I'm lower, sometimes I'm higher. It's just the way it is here in Maryland. And I'm sure if it was flat, this would actually probably go further too. Anyways, thanks guys, thanks for watching. I appreciate it. Please subscribe if it's the first time here. I'm trying to make more videos again. I've just been so busy and I just haven't been doing it. But my other channel is taking off pretty well, so I've been spending a little more time there. But thanks for coming by, and if you have any questions about this radio, I'll try to answer them as best I can. But MURS is the winner. All right, guys, I'll see you in the next one. Take care.